Hi everyone, I'm Dominic. Surely you will be surprised because this time I returned to the animal battle. After a long time not doing. The reason is if I like it, I just do it. As usual, I will first analyze the traits and interesting facts of each animal. Then it will be the analysis which will win.
1. Jawad. The Jawad is a compact and well-muscled animal. It is the largest cat native to the Americas and the third largest in the world, exceeded in size by the tiger and the lion. Its coat is generally a tawny yellow, but ranges to reddish brown for most of the body. The ventral areas are white. The fur is covered with roses for camouflage in the dapple light of its forest habitat. The spots and their shapes vary between individual jawas. Rosettes may include one or several dots. The jawas' present range extends from the extreme southwestern United States and Mexico in North America, across much of Central America, and south to Paraguay and northern Argentina in South America. The spotted cat closely resembles the leopard, but is usually larger and sturdier. It ranges across a variety of forested and open terrains, but its preferred habitat is tropical and subtropical moist broadleaf forests, swamps, and wooded regions. The jawad enjoys swimming and is largely a solitary, opportunistic, stalk and ambush predator at the top of the food chain. As a keystone species, it plays an important role in stabilizing ecosystems and regulating prey populations. The word jawar comes from the indigenous word yawad, which means he who kills with one leap. Its size and weight vary considerably. Weights are normally in the range of 56 to 96 kilograms, 123 to 212 pounds. Exceptionally big males have been recorded to weigh as much as 158 kilograms, 348 pounds. It is sexually dimorphic, with females typically 10 to 20% smaller than males. The length from the nose to the base of the tail varies from 1.12 to 1.85 meters. The jawar stands 63 to 76 centimeters tall at the shoulders. There are many sources of data on jawas' top running speed. At the moment, I don't know which one is correct. 80 km per hour, 64 km per hour, or 50 km per hour. A short and stocky limb structure makes the jawas adept at climbing, crawling, and swimming. The head is robust and the jaw extremely powerful. A 100 kg jawar can bite with a force of 1,110 pounds force with the canine teeth and 1,556 pounds at the canaceal notch. Jawas are excellent swimmers. Unlike many domestic cats, jawas don't avoid water. They often live near lakes, rivers, and wetlands, and are confident swimmers known to cross large rivers. Both males and females roar, which helps bring them together when they want to mate. A jawas usually call is called a saw because it sounds like the sawing of wood, but with the saw only moving in one direction. When jawas greet each other or reassure one another, they make a noise like a nasally snuffling. Jawas are opportunistic hunters and can prey upon almost anything they come across. Capybaras, deer, tortoises, iguanas, armadillos, fish, birds, and monkeys are just some of the prey that jawas eat. They can even tackle South America's largest animal, the tapir, and huge predators like caiman. Jawas hunt both in the day and at night and usually travel up to 10 kilometers, over 6 miles a night when hunting. Jawas have a more powerful bite than any other big cat. Their teeth are strong enough to bite through the thick hides of crocodilians and the hard shells of turtles. They need powerful teeth and jaws to take their prey 3 to 4 times their own weight, usually killing it with a bite to the back of the skull rather than biting the neck or throat like other big cats. Komodo dragon. The Komodo dragon, also known as the Komodo monitor, is a species of lizard found in Indonesian island of Komodo, Rinca, Force, and Gili Mortang. It is the largest extant species of lizards. As a result of their size, these lizards dominate the ecosystems in which they live. Komodo dragons hunt and ambush prey, including invertebrates, birds, and mammals. It has been claimed that they have a venomous bite. There are two glands in the lower jaw which secrete several toxic proteins. The biological significance of these proteins is disputed, but the glands have been shown to secrete an anticoagulant. Komodo dragons' group behavior in hunting is exceptional in the reptile world. The diet of big Komodo dragons mainly consists of Timo deer, though they also eat considerable amounts of carrion. Komodo dragons also occasionally attack humans. According to Guinness World Records, an average adult male will weigh 79 to 91 kilograms, 174 to 201 pounds, and measure 2.59 meters, 8.5 feet, while an average female will weigh 68 to 73 kilograms, 150 to 161 pounds, and measure 2.29 meters, 7.5 feet. The largest verified wild specimen was 3.13 meters, 10.3 feet long, and weighed 166 kilograms, 366 pounds, including its undigested food. The Komodo dragon has a tail as long as its body, as well as about 60 frequently replaced serrated teeth, can measure up to 2.5 centimeters, 1 inch in length. Its saliva is frequently blood-tinged because its teeth are almost completely covered by gingival tissue that is naturally lacerated during feeding. It also has a long, yellow, deeply forked tongue. Komodo dragon skin is reinforced by enameled scales, which contain tiny bones called osteoderms that function as a sort of natural trained mail. Additionally, these osteoderms become more extensive and variable in shape as the Komodo dragon ages, ossifying more extensively as the lizard grows. These osteoderms are absent in hatchling and juveniles, indicating that the natural armor develops as a product of age and competition between adults for protection in intraspecific combat over food and mates. As with many other reptiles, the Komodo dragon primarily relies on its tongue to detect taste and smell stimuli. With the vomero nasal sense using the Jacobson's organ rather than using the nostrils. With the help of a favorable wind and its habit of swinging its head from side to side as it walks, a Komodo dragon may be able to detect a carrion from 4 to 9.5 kilometers, 2.5 to 5.9 miles away. The Komodo dragon prefers hot and dry places and typically lives in dry open grassland, savanna, and tropical forests at low elevations. As an ectotherm, it is most active in the day, although it exhibits some nocturnal activity. Komodo dragons are solitary, coming together only to breed and eat. They are capable of running rapidly in brief sprints up to 20 km per hour, 12 miles per hour, diving up to 4.5 meters, 15 feet, and climbing trees proficiently when young through use of their strong claws. To catch out of reach prey, the Komodo dragon may stand on its hind legs and use its tails as a support. As it matures, its claws are usually primarily as weapons, as its great size makes climbing impractical. For shelter, the Komodo dragon digs holes that can measure from 1 to 3 meters, 3.3 to 9.8 feet wide with its powerful forelimbs and claws. Because of its large size and habit of sleeping in these burrows, it is able to conserve body heat throughout the night and minimize its basking period the morning after. The Komodo dragon hunts in the afternoon, but stays in the shade during the hottest part of the day. The special resting places, usually located on ridges with cool sea breezes, are marked with dropping and are clear of vegetation. They served as a strategic locations from which to ambush deer. They are carnivores, meat eaters who like to eat pigs, deer, snakes, fish, and water buffalo. Adult Komodo dragons are cannibals, eat their own species, and 10% of their diet is made of newly hatched Komodo dragons. They can eat prey that weighs 80% of their own weight in one meal. Unlike other animals, they will eat bones and hooves. They usually hunt during the day because they don't see well during the night. Other than that, Komodo has a poor sense of hearing. Komodo dragons have reddish saliva that contains 50 different types of bacteria. Recent experiments have shown that saliva contains venom that probably contributes to a deadly effect of bite. Only one bite induces blood poisoning of their prey. Professor Fry said attacks on pigs and deer were extremely successful, with about 75% bleeding to death within 30 minutes and a further 15% dying within 3 to 4 hours from venom in the salivary glands of the Komodo dragons. Komodo dragons often fight with other dragons. They bite each other during the fight, but unlike other animals, they are immune to bacteria and venom from their saliva. Analysis of the battle. Apparently, the two opponents of today were both very strong, both at the top of their food chain. Both have respectable offensive and defensive weapons. In fact, they live in different environments and geographical locations, so they will never have a chance to fight with each other. But let's say, if these two have to fight, let's try to analyze which one has a higher winning rate. First, in terms of size, it can be said that they are about the same size. I will also choose two with equal weight for this match. Jaguar dominates in speed, strength, and extremely strong jaws. Komodo dragon has good armor, venom, and bacterial bite. Jaguars are adept at killing caimans by biting through their skulls. These caimans are about as large as Komodo and even have armor at least as good as the Komodo dragon. The jaguar even successfully killed a caiman without being bitten, so jaguars can completely kill a Komodo in a similar way. However, the two forelimbs of the Komodo dragon are very strong, unlike that of the crocodile, so he will not let the jaguar bite him easily. Also, if the jaguar is bitten, it will surely die, perhaps 3 to 4 hours after being bitten. However, during this time, it was still able to kill the Komodo dragon first. I think the jaguar's winning rate when being bitten by the dragon is about 70%. Thus, the rate of winning of the jaguar is higher. However, it had to avoid the dragon's bite to preserve its life. Otherwise, it would be a draw and both would die. Okay, so my battle analysis is over. If you like it, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. And also suggest topics you want me to do in the comment section. Goodbye and see you soon.